I'm going to show you a tool where you can create great looking App Store screenshots fast and with no design skills, because we're developers, we're not designers. It'll also localize your screenshots into many different languages, and when you export, you can export it to Android, iOS, just iPhone, iPad, saving you so much time. And yes, this video is sponsored by AppScreens, the tool that we're going to use, but after they reached out and I played around with the tool for a little bit, like, I'm converted. I'm gonna use AppScreens for my apps going forward. I mean, look, here's what I used to do. Here's my crazy big sketch file. I had to find all the device frames myself, mask the screenshots to fit in there, design everything. It was just so tedious, so time consuming, and such a pain. And AppScreens just takes all that away. It just saves me so much time as an indie dev. All right, let me show you this thing in action. Here I am at the main AppScreens website. And in my opinion, there's three different levels on how you can use AppScreens. Level one would be, I just need some decent looking screenshots, maybe some basic localization on iPhone and iPad, and I need that fast. And level two would be where you take an existing template, customize it a bit to match your brand, kind of like you see here. And then level three is when you would start with a blank slate using their powerful editor and just start completely from scratch. And in this video, I'm gonna demonstrate levels one and two. All right, so for level one, which again was just I need some decent looking screenshots, localization, and I need it fast. So for that, luckily, hey, look, there's a button right here, create screenshots fast. And the three options here kind of match the levels I was talking about. This AI screenshot creator can get us stuff fast. You can copy a template as a starting point, customize it. That would kind of be like level two. And then again, the blank slate, blank project would be level three. So we're gonna go level one, AI screenshot editor. We're gonna search for creator view. That's my own personal indie app. Click on that. And now it's creating. So what it's doing is it's going out to the App Store, looking at my app, getting all the metadata, learning about it, and bringing that information in so I can use it. As you see, it just popped up. Track revenue, plan content, manage expenses, analyze growth. And that's short form. If you click here, you go to long form. This is a more verbose version of some text that we're gonna put at the top of our screenshots. Effortlessly track your YouTube revenue, plan and schedule your content. So you can switch between long form or short form. I'm gonna stick to short form. And you can go default, which is the ASO expert. You can have it use emojis. You can change the tone, direct, friendly, inspire, persuasive. We're just gonna stick with the default and it's generating more information. So now we're gonna go ahead and select our template. So this is what I was talking about. AppScreens has tons of templates. I'm gonna scroll pretty quick just to give you a preview. Not gonna scroll down the whole list because that would take a while, but you can see some nice looking layouts, nice different color designs. And again, you can either just plug your screenshots into this and be done, or you can customize each of these templates to match your brand. So I'm gonna scroll back up to a pretty simple template. Again, for our level one, super fast, this dark, simple, bold. So I'm gonna select the template. And it's creating the preview for Creator View. And by the way, we brought in my app Creator View. If your app's not on the App Store, you can type into a text field, a paragraph, all about your app, giving it the information, and then it will pull things like track revenue, plan content, manage expenses, based on that paragraph that you told it. So we don't have our screenshots yet, but you can see the words at the top of our screenshots are already in there. So I'm gonna hit save and edit, and now we need to name this. So I'll name this Creator View Simple. And you can write in about if you need this information for A/B testing. You can add tags, change the orientation, portrait or landscape. We're gonna look at output sizes because again, the power of AppScreens, you design your screenshot once and you get like Android, Android tablet, Apple Watch, iPhone, iPad. We're gonna uncheck Android because you know we're iOS developers here, but we're gonna keep iOS iPhones and iPads. Now we can set our localization languages here. We're gonna hold off on that for now. So I'm gonna hit create and we're gonna go into our editor with our basic template. And again, the words will already be at the top based on what it pulled in. Now, if this isn't exactly what you want, you know, track revenue, stay on top of earnings, plan content, plan videos effectively. Of course, you can come in here and edit this, edit the title, the subtitle, the font, all kinds of stuff, the device type. Open this up, right? You can change the device style, the device angle. Again, you can customize all this, which we're gonna do when we do level two. But again, for now, hit the check mark. We are just talking about level one. I need some screenshots. I need them fast. So we got the text on our screens right now. Again, you can tweak it if this is not exactly what you want. Let's upload our AppScreens. So hit the AppScreens button up here. So here's where we can drag and drop from our Finder, our iPhone and iPad screenshots. So I'm gonna go to my Finder. I've already taken screenshots, as you can see over here on the right, save some time. But this first screen, track revenue. So let's do iPad money. That's my revenue screen. Drag that into the iPad. We'll do iPhone money. Drag that over to the iPhone. Cool. Screen two is plan content. Okay, so that's my schedule. Back to Finder. We'll do iPad schedule. Drop that onto the iPad. We'll do iPhone schedule. Drop that onto the iPhone. I think you get the gist on how to do this. I'm gonna bring in the rest of my screens, but I'm gonna edit that out to keep the video flowing. So I've brought in the rest of my screens. I'm gonna hit save down here in the lower right. There are all my screens. I'm gonna scroll over. We're gonna delete these last two just because I didn't have enough screens for them. Delete that. You don't have to do all your screens, or you can if you want them all. And we'll delete that last one. So just like that, I have some basic, decent screenshots with the text pulled in from AI and my screens right there. Now let me show you how easy it is to get some localization. So you see this dropdown right here, language preview. Let's add some languages. So we want to use the AI translator. Let's add Spanish and French and German, right? German's always a fun one to localize into because the words are always so long. So now we'll hit update. And then now in my dropdown, right, I see German. Here are my German screenshots coming right up soon. There they are. So now we got German, and you're noticing the actual screen devices aren't in German because I didn't actually take those from my device. But if I were to do that, when I upload my app screens here, you see on the right, once I've set up languages, I have German, Spanish, French. Right now it's gonna be all my English ones, but if you did have screenshots for each language, this is where you would upload those accordingly. So back to the screens here, again, that's German. Let's look at Spanish. Cool, and there is Spanish. And then now let's look at iPad. So it's iPhone, iPad. Here's iPad in Spanish. Here is iPad in German. So you see, just like that, we'll go back to iPhone and English. You saw how long that took me, right? I did that live in real time. And now I have screenshots for iPhone, for iPad, in Spanish, French, and German. So the final step would be to preview and export. So it's rendering the previews. Again, you get all the iPhones, the iPad. You can cycle through per language just to get a little preview of it. And then you can either download them as a zip, or you can authenticate with the App Store and upload them directly to the App Store right from AppScreens. We're not going to do that because the whole authentication process takes a little bit, but that is possible to just go right to the App Store from here. So you see, that took me no time at all to get all those variations of screenshots, and they look pretty decent. This is a very basic template. You may not like this design, but luckily, AppScreens has a restyle tool. So you see, we have our text all set up at the top. We got our screens brought in. If I hit this restyle screenshots button, now I can go to any other template. Let's go, let's just keep it simple here. We'll go to this colorful dynamic waves, select template, and then you see it brought over my text, track revenue, plan content, manage expenses. It's not previewing my screenshots just yet, but if I hit save in projects, call this creator view version 2, hit create, project saved, okay. Now, if I go to my projects, here's creator view version 2, open and edit. And now here we are, my screenshots, my text right there. And you can see I already have my localization set up. I can go to Spanish just like that with this new style in Spanish. So you can see how easily you can just switch from template to template, which really lends itself to good A/B testing. But let's say you want to customize the background, customize the devices. You really like the layout of a template, but you want to make it your own and match your brand again, kind of like you see here. So to do that, we're going to restyle into a much different template here. It's kind of down far, it's called Midnight. And the reason this template is different, you're also getting a preview of all the wide variety of cool screenshot templates here. So the reason this one is different is if you look, come on, it's coming up, right? There it is. Diverse Midnight Panoramic. Look at the three devices here, and we got some icons up there. So I'm gonna select this template to restyle into. Now, it's gonna mess up because our current style has one screenshot per screenshot. And if you look, this has three devices going across the first two screenshots, and some of the devices span two different screenshots. So this is a little more tricky. I am gonna hit save in project. I'm gonna say creator view version 3. Obviously my naming is very generic right now. You would name that something more intelligent. Project saved, okay. Go to projects, and I wanna go to creator view version 3, open and edit. And now again, this is gonna be messed up because it doesn't quite know what to do for this three device things. But you see, it did know what to do for these. Manage expenses, visualize growth, set goals, analyze analytics, track revenue. Well, we're gonna delete this one. That's a repeat there. But yes, delete that. And we're only gonna customize the first couple screens just to, you know, you'll get the point after that. But I wanna address this messing up because last time we manually dragged and dropped our screens over, and that can be pretty tedious, especially if you have seven different languages, iPhone and iPad, maybe Apple Watch. There is a nice way where you can upload a structured folder where it just does all that for you. And that really comes in handy when you have multiple devices like this, multiple layers on screenshots here. So I'm gonna go to AppScreens and we're gonna upload folder. So we'll automatically import screenshots from a structured folder. And this structure is what really matters here. So I'm gonna go to learn more. You can see the structure. So there's a certain path and then the way you label them for languages and the order. So you want to do 01, 02, 03, 04, because if we go back to our layout here, what it's going to do, hit cancel. So you see this layout, it's basically going to import the screens in order. And if you saw, it said from bottom to top. So my number one screenshot is going to be this one that's peeking out here. You see the 22, because that's the bottom of the first screenshot. And then this would be number two, the one that's on the top. And then my screenshot number three here on the second screenshot panel would be the schedule right here. And then my screenshot number four would be the other half of this money one right here. So you need to really pay attention to how you structure that folder. And it may sound like a lot of tedious upfront work, but again, if you're trying to upload all this for 7 different languages, iPhone, iPad, Apple Watch, structuring your folder on your screenshots and just uploading a folder saves you a stupid amount of time. So again, let's go back to that AppScreens upload folder. Now, if I go to my folder here, I'm gonna select folder, and I have my app screenshots with my iPhone with en-us for all my screens. I'll hit cancel real quick because you see it has to match this perfectly. English, en-us, or German, DE, or Spanish, ES, French. Hit select the folder. And again, if you had tons of languages, you would have an iPad folder, an iPhone folder, all the languages properly structured. And that would just save you an insane amount of time when uploading all your screens. So I'm gonna hit select on this app screenshots folder. And you see it pulled it in. Here's my file path. Here it is assigned to the US iPhone 6.9. Again, if I had iPad or various languages, it would show you what got assigned to what. So you can check to make sure like this is good. So I'm gonna import assigned files. Yes, we're gonna overwrite my already upload screenshots because they were a little messed up. We'll let this work for a little bit, and it should, if I numbered them correctly and ordered them correctly, put them in the exact right spots for that specific screenshot where it has three devices. So I'm gonna hit save. Save my progress. Okay, all my screenshots came in imperfect because this one's tricky. So you see on this first screenshot, I really have part of my schedule and my money screen. But on the second screenshot, I got my dashboard, my schedule, and then down here in the bottom left, part of that money screen is peeking out from the bottom. So you got to make sure you order that correctly. And then these other ones are pretty straightforward. Now let's start customizing this to match my brand a little bit. So first things first, I want to change the background from this starry night. So we'll hit background right here and we'll go to new background. Now you can upload your own image or you can go to Unsplash, which has tons and tons and tons of images, right? You can see Unsplash. I'm going to go to gradients on Unsplash, see all different kinds of gradients. Doesn't have one that quite matches my brand. I believe it was in preset images. And then down here in light gradient is where I found this. Of course, you got to surf around to find what you want. But there's some pretty cool gradients in here, but this seemed to match my brand nicely. And then you can go like bottom, middle, top of the image. I think I saw top get made it a little more darker that matched what I wanted, but you can see how you can play around with this. So cool, there's the background set and it's the gradient that spans across all the screenshots, right? It's not like one gradient per screenshot. So it looks really nice and cohesive. Now let's mess with our device styles. So I'm gonna go to the device here and you can start to see the power of the editor here. So for the device frame, I want the 3D device mockup, but I wanna tilt it to the right a little bit. You see how it tilted to the right? But it's a realistic phone. Now, device style, we can keep it dark, gold, light, but I like this matte dark, so that's what we're gonna go with. The matte dark style, cool. That's what I'm going for. And you can see, you can change landscape left, landscape right, all different kinds of customizations you can do. But we're good on this one. Now I wanna go to device one, layer at the bottom, that little part of my schedule, and do the same thing. So I want 3D mockup left. I want this one tilting to the left a little bit. And then again, the dark matte style. Now, you can copy styles and apply it to the rest of your screenshots, so you don't have to do this one by one. However, this one's a little tricky because as you can see, I'm tilting this one right, tilting this one left. There's no like one universal style to apply. You'll see when I get to manage expenses, I can't apply the style to all these other screenshots because they're all the same. Again, this first two screens where there's multiple devices and layers makes it a little tricky to, you know, blanket copy everything. So now let's go to our font here, track revenue. We'll go to title settings, scroll up here. Track revenue is fine. Again, you can tweak what you want this to be. I'm going to give it a background color and pretty solid color. And I'm gonna pull in from the dropper, the pink on my bars here. Give it a background, just give it a little bit of texture there. And again, this background, you can corner radius. You can make it a little round, give it padding. So you can customize like every little bit of this here. And for the font family, we're gonna go to Google Fonts. You can import your own custom font if you wanna bring in the San Francisco family of fonts. We're gonna stick to the Google ones. We'll just do enter, hit select, and we're gonna make this bold. Oh, I gotta highlight the text before I make it bold. There we go. So now you see our first screenshot, track revenue, and our devices are styled. So we're gonna do this next screen, and then the manage expense screen, and then I'll show you I can blanket the rest of the style, and I'll show you how to change these icons as well. All right, so let's start with our dashboard here. Device one, the bottom, again, frame. We're gonna keep it flat, we're not gonna rotate this one. We're going to do matte dark, Cool, that's good to go. Except we're gonna give it a shadow here. You can see this shadow area. And I like the blur to be like 70, and you can drag this around to like the angle of the shadow. I like to type it in so I can be specific for each one rather than trying to like drag it in. And for the color, yeah, we'll do 35. We'll keep it uniform, 35. So a nice subtle shadow, as you can see right here on the phone. So it looks like the light source is from the upper left shining down. And then device two, our schedule here, we'll do the same thing as well. 3D mockup left. Remember, we're tilting that one to the left. And then matte dark gray. And we'll give that a shadow as well. Solid color, say blur of 70, X and Y of 35, 35, and color alpha of 35. A nice subtle shadow there. And let's not forget about the tiny corner of our device down there. Let's make sure that is 3D device mockup right, and then matte dark as well to complete that screen. Okay, and if you wanted to, you can mess with the layout here. You can edit the layout, see how it's all laid out. You can title, device, padding, image. Again, this is the full power of the editor here. We're gonna stick to just customizing the look of this one. So we got our first two screens. So now I'll do this third one. We'll change the icon, change the text, and then we'll blanket apply our style to the rest of them so you can see how that works. So pretty easy here. Device, we're gonna go flat device mockup, matte dark. For the title and subtitle, again, title settings, we'll say this is bold, family of enter for the font, select, and then the background, give it a solid color. We'll make it a dark teal here, and just to give it some texture, make it stand out a little bit. Again, we'll do some rounding. I can't remember the exact percentage I did, but whatever, you can get how you can dial that in. And then now this icon up here, right? This has nothing to do with Siri, but we can change this out just like we changed out the background. So I'm gonna go to new image. Again, you can bring in your own image. Unsplash has a bunch. There's some preset images. If you're into the Apple ecosystem, you can put a bunch on there. I'm gonna bring in my own images because I had ChatGPT create me some icons. So this is my expense icon, little receipt with a magnifying glass. Hit open, you can bring that in. Oh, that's a little small. If we click on it, see, we get the menu here, move, resize, delete. We can resize it. I'm gonna change the height a little bit. Remember, this is percentages, so a little bit goes a long way. Yeah, that's way too much. But you can kind of dial it in as you like. Here, we'll go down to like 11. And then you see it has a shadow by default. We're gonna get rid of that shadow right here. Just no shadow, please. And then now here's that copy settings. I wanted copy settings from screenshot 3. I'm gonna copy to screenshot 4, 5, and 6 because 1 and 2 are already done. And I wanna do text styles, device type, and not the screenshots. Okay, so be careful what you're copying over. So go ahead and hit copy, save, and then now if I check this, scroll over. Now, of course, the icon didn't change, but now I get the devices, I get the font with the background. We can really take the time to dial this in. I can add different icons, but I think you get the idea. And now, look, I'm not saying these screenshots are gonna win awards or they're perfect, but you saw me mess around with this for like 5 to 6 minutes. Obviously, you would put a little more time into that, but such a powerful tool. You can go from this original template right here to something that looks like this, that still needs more tweaks, but you get the idea of where it's going in just a few minutes. So such a powerful tool. And again, this can be localized, Spanish. Here they are in Spanish. If I click the localize button, we can do some advanced localization here where we can go to each screenshot. So say screenshot 1, and we can override this if we want. If we unclick automatic translation, I can come in here and change this myself. And that's because AI translated. And you know what? Different countries, different cultures, maybe they want to say something different, right? Maybe an exact translation isn't what you want for a specific country or culture. So you can come in and override that AI translation if you like. So I'm gonna go ahead, hit save, we're good there. And we'll go back to English. And again, you have your preview and export, just like we did with our original ones, where you can go language by language, device by device, to make sure these are looking good. Like, we didn't even look at the iPad yet, but as you can see, the iPad would need some work because we didn't bring in our screenshots, but you get the idea on how you can take a template and customize it. So AppScreens is an awesome tool. Like I said, it saves you an insane amount of time, especially when you're dealing with multiple devices, iPhone, iPad, 7 different languages. You can easily iterate between styles, do a lot of A/B testing. It's just an incredible tool. Like I said, I am converted. Again, here is the old sketch file that I was using, and I wasn't even doing localization. So you can imagine how this would have ballooned if I was doing localization. So yeah, I'm a believer now. And here is the pricing, right? There is a free tool that'll give you a little bit of the benefits, but you can see what you get here with the $675 per month, which I think is a steal for the time savings you get. So check out appscreens.com, bring in your app, play around, see what you can create. I think you're gonna love it.